Well, here we are at the second Doddy Day Bake Off, and my friend Ellis is going to tell us a lot more about it than I know.
Well, we've been invited back, so we must have done a good job last year.
I think so.
So thanks for having us. Anyway, we've got two wonderful young women chefs in the kitchen who've been baking all day, their socks off.
Yes.
They are producing some beautiful cakes all about happiness.
I'm Beth. I'm originally from Essex, but I'm happy to call Liverpool home now. I have for 5 years. I work at Luban restaurant for Dave Critchley now as their pastry chef, and it's brilliant. I'm having a great time. I love it.
I'm Ellie. I originally come from Prescott. I work at Liverpool with Ellis. I'm a pastry chef there, trying to figure out loads of exciting new dishes and things like that to please some local foodies, really.
Okay, chefs, stand by your whisks. This is where the fun begins. Ready.
Steady.
Bake.
Ellie and Beth have only been given 3 hours to complete a bake masterpiece with the theme of Ken Dodd's happiness.
So what we're looking for from the chefs today is a real fork gone into the idea of the cake. Good quality presentation, a nice clean and tidy work ethic, but also great flavour, because great flavour brings smiley faces.
I've made the base of my cake, essentially. I'm trying to get in the oven rather quick, try and beat her, then I've got a bit more time. I've got a jam on, because obviously Ken Dodd's jam butties. I sat down, and I was making a plan, and I was thinking, oh, it's got to be a mine, there's got to be a village, we've got to have little people. Drew it all, and then I was like, wow, this is a lot. So hopefully get it all done.
Actually, I'll have a sneak peek because I think Ellie might have planned a few more elements than she might have time for, but let's wait and see. Let's hope she can manage it. I wonder.
I'm doing a cake based off the song by Ken Dodd called Happiness, where he describes his happiness as like an ocean tide. So I'm doing a cake on like an island in the ocean. So that's going to be a lemon cake with a lemon buttercream and a curd, decorated with crushed biscuits and fondant decorations. And hopefully, if I have time, a little figure of Ken himself. But I'm not going to put money on that.
Ellie's off to the races with her cake in the oven.
Hopefully that bakes in time.
But Beth isn't too far behind.
I'm just making my lemon curd now, which will go in the middle of my layers between the buttercream.
Best will scramble the lemon curd. Cost a lot of time and effort. No one likes scrambled egg in the cake.
What I'm most worried about today is the timing of the decorating. Because it's not like a majorly elaborate cake, but some of the aspects will take time. So I've just got to hope that my little fingers can move fast enough to make it happen.
I think I'm most worried about timing. Maybe, I don't know, cake burning and then having to start all over again, have a whole like Ian off the Bake Off Baked Alaska kind of thing. It was sabotage. I have very, very strong feelings.
So watch your back, huh?
Oh, oh, is that a threat?
It's a promise, love.
So at the minute I work at Liverpool, recent start, so still very much finding my feet. My favourite thing is probably getting to interact with customers, because everywhere else I've worked as a pastry chef, you're always in some back cupboard somewhere. I enjoy explaining things to people, hearing where people have come from. Ellis is great. Ellis, if you're watching this, you're great. I love you. It's an oven. It's my oven.
Don't forget your oven, Ellie.
I think it might still be a little bit underdone in the middle. Raw cake batter is delicious, but I don't want to serve it today.
Do you know how to turn these hobs on?
Yes, so.
Get this, I'm helping. If she wins,
I'm so grateful.
I've helped.
I could attribute my success to you. So I work at Luban, which is a Chinese fine dining restaurant. Executive chef is Dave Critchley, who was, you might have known from Great British Menu. He's there doing it again this year. I've worked there for about a month now as their pastry chef, and honestly, it's brilliant, having a great time. I think my favourite thing is definitely the kitchen team, because they've been so friendly and welcoming right from the start. I felt right at home straight from the beginning, so that's definitely my favourite, I think.
she feels done. This is an exciting time. And I've beaten her, don't know by how many minutes, but I've beaten her. So everything's going according to plan. It's when I drop it now, jinxed it now. Right. Whew. Smell that, it's good. Hmm?
That smells really good. Mm.
She's jealous. She knows.
Oh no, wait till you smell mine.
Fair enough.
What do you think Ken would have thought?
Oh, we would have loved it. We love to encourage young people in their jobs and to love it and to feel for it.
My dad, as soon as he found out I was doing this, loved it, told me all about how he used to go and see him near Old Hay and in Prescott, and how like he'd go to like shows and say finish at 10 and then he'd be there till stupid o'clock.
He's a local legend, isn't he? But seeing the mural in town and heard his name around, seen a couple of his skits without even really realising it, heard his songs.
It's just a good part of Liverpool history really, isn't it? It's just something that everyone really should know about.
He did such good with his life and he's still doing it even afterwards, so it's a lovely story.
They really should have a whole day dedicated to him.
So my cakes are ready to go now. They've risen quite a lot, which is good. I'll trim the tops off. You can see they've browned quite a bit. They've got a bit of a crisp top, but I'm going to pour a lemon syrup over them so that'll soften up nicely.
Okay, chefs, it's time to decorate. Go.
Finished now. Ready for the next bit.
Oops, Beth, can't make a cake without breaking a few eggs or spilling some flour.
Why are you filming this? I'm going to pipe some seaweed on the outside of the cake so it looks like, you know, under the water. I'm just going to do three different colours for that, a blue, a green and a purple. And the filling and covering buttercream is going to be blue to look like the sea. This should be really strong, so I didn't mean to put that in there. That was meant for the fondant. There we go, it's all good. Good. You can delete that footage, thanks.
Nah, we'll keep it, thanks. Ellie's had her cake out first, but has the tide turned as Beth is storming ahead with her decorating skills?
Very luckily, the Diddy Men houses are not very square, which I'm very, very grateful for right now, under the time pressure.
Just cutting the cakes. Now ready to fill and stack them.
She's a belter, it's all good. She's a belter.
Travis, spare piping bag.
Yes.
I'm really stealing stuff.
It's all good. Teamwork, innit?
This is supposed to be a competition.
The jam's set very well, so I'm very happy.
My curd has also set very well.
Hopefully, all my decorations fit on top. If they don't, no hassle. That would be great if I have more than I need. It's just going to be a big push to get it all done in time.
I'm just filling my cake now with my buttercream and curd, and then I'll give it a quick crumb coat and set it up in the fridge before I can fully cover it in the buttercream.
Beth and Ellie are really bringing the heat this year, but who is going to take the crown? Find out in part 2.